Yeah, that's perfect. We... No, come on now! Hey there! Welcome to DIY in 5. My name's Trisha Hershberger, and today we're going to go over some simple ways to copy photos from an iPhone without using a computer. We've all been there. You're out and about, doing your thing, or maybe on vacation, and bam! No more storage, just at the picture-perfect moment. Never fear, I got you covered. What do we say to limited storage? Not today. The first method we'll talk about is super simple, surprisingly portable, and uses an itty-bitty flash drive made just for this purpose. This is the Bolt USB from Kingston, designed specifically to be used with an iPhone or iPad. There are other options out there, like the Leaf iBridge, but for this demonstration, we'll use the Bolt. Transferring photos using the Bolt is a snap. Just plug the Bolt into your phone, and you'll see a prompt to download the Bolt app from the App Store. Every time you plug in the device, you'll have to click Allow to allow the two devices to communicate. From there, you can click Transfer, decide what you'd like to transfer, and then you even have the option to keep or delete the original photos on the device after transfer, instead of you having to do it manually. Thanks, Kingston! The Bolt is super tiny and can easily be stored on your keychain when you're out and about. Now, since it's so tiny, you may be worried about it getting misplaced and falling into the wrong hands. Security-wise, you can change the app settings to use a passcode or Touch ID each time the app opens, just in case. The Bolt comes in a variety of different capacity and price point options, and it even allows you to record or capture directly to the Bolt if you are really in a rush and don't want to transfer before getting that great shot. Options, they're neat. If you'd rather back up and transfer photos and videos using cloud storage, there are many options out there for this as well. This is arguably a less secure way to go, given data breaches in the past, but requires no secondary device to make the magic happen. It does, however, require a Wi-Fi connection. Let's start with the iCloud, since we are specifically dealing with iOS for this video. After finding a Wi-Fi connection, go to Settings, Your Name, and tap iCloud, then iCloud Backup, then Backup Now. If you'd rather have iCloud do this automatically each day when plugged in and connected to Wi-Fi, you can turn on iCloud Backup in your settings and voila, done. Provided you have enough available space in your iCloud, that is. Packages start as low as 99 cents per month if you need to add more. Now, if you'd rather use another cloud storage option like Google Drive or Dropbox, there are apps to make that easier too. The Google Drive app for iOS makes transferring and auto backup simple. You'll see similar transfer options like we showed before, and you can turn on auto backup by going to Settings, Photos, then toggle on the switch for auto backup. Dropbox has a similar app as well, however, you must be a Dropbox Plus or professional account holder to enable their camera uploads feature, which is their auto backup option. But what if you like the security of transferring to a local device, but have a ton to back up, like I'm talking a terabyte or more? Well, then you may even want to consider an external hard drive. And yes, some of these are designed to skip the computer as the middleman. The Lacey Fuel wireless hard drive is a great example. It's wireless with up to 10 hours of battery life, so you can take it with you and transfer photos and videos on the go using built-in Wi-Fi. Then there are great NAS drive options. NAS stands for Network Attached Storage, and these are dedicated storage devices that connect to your home router so that your files are available to you from any device when you're on the go. WD's MyCloud is an example of such a device that has a very good iOS app, making advanced tasks like remote access and family sharing simple for a new user. Plus, you can get models with up to 20 terabytes of storage, or buy the chassis empty and install your own hard drives for a custom storage setup. So there we have it. Photos transferred sans Mac or PC. How do you like to back up your data? Let us know in the comments. And if you're looking to up your iPhone photography game, check out these other videos on our channel. P.S. My shot from earlier turned out great. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you next time with more DIY in 5.